Let me tell you about some fun facts. Let's try to talk about maleic acid and fumaric acid. Yeah, maleic acid is soluble in water. Pretty nice. This guy, not so soluble. Maleic acid is quite acidic, fumaric acid not that acidic. And if we look at the melting points, maleic acid melts at around 135 degrees Celsius, whereas fumaric acid melts at around 287 degrees Celsius, yes. Now, the fun thing over here is, let me tell you about their IUPAC name. Both of these are butuene dioic acids. Yes, the same IUPAC nomenclature. Why is this happening? Let me show you their structures. Just notice their structures carefully. Aren't they too similar? Yes, they are. But notice the difference. Across the double bond, the orientation of the COOH groups is different. Yes, and this subtle difference is what causes so many differences in their properties. Now, why does this happen? This happens because of a certain phenomena that is known as restricted rotation. My dear friends, my name is Pahul. I have Abhishek sir with me. You are watching Vedantu's YouTube channel. I'll be right back. Alright, so I hope you enjoyed that fun fact. As I told you, it happens because of restricted rotation. Yes. Now let us see what restricted rotation means for us when we look at some chemical compounds. Yes. So, where can restricted rotation exist? Everyone knows this, that it does exist in the case of a double bond. Yeah. So let's say I have a very simple CH3 bonded to a CH3. Yes. Ye kya hai? Ethane, simple sa. Now in this case, this is just a sigma bond. Yes. How does the sigma bond look like? When we look at the hybrid picture, this is what the sigma bond looks like. Kuch aise bana hoga, yes. Head on overlap. Now what happens is, this bond can easily rotate, as you can see my arms. It can easily rotate, yeah. So these hydrogens over here, these three hydrogens, ye jo lines banayi hai maine, these are for hydrogens. Now these hydrogens can freely rotate. Okay. So imagine this is my sigma bond and my fingers are, let's say, the hydrogen groups. Okay. Yeah, three hydrogen groups. So these can easily rotate, yeah. Aise dekh lo. Yeah, these can easily rotate, and this is the basis for conformational isomers, which we'll do in the next class. Today we are looking at geometrical isomers where we have restricted rotation. Yes. So maan lo, yahan pe ek piece of paper tha. Agar ek nail dala usme, if you put just one pin to attach it to the wall, it'll just sway around like this. I'm sure you know. Let's say I put another pin. So as soon as I've created another hinge point over here, this paper will not rotate. Yeah. Similarly, what happens in chemistry is that when you have a double bond, your rotation gets restricted. Okay. So let's take the simplest example of all. Yeah. Something like this. Okay. Imagine this is butuene. Yeah. So butuene ka example lenge apan yahan pe. So what's happening over here, if I focus on just this bond, I'll tell you why this restricted rotation happens, and then we'll just see a lot of cases of geometrical isomerism. So ho kya raha hai? There is one sigma bond, of course, which is happening via the head-on overlap of these hybrid sp2 orbitals. Yes, because these two carbons are sp2. Now what about the pi bonds? If you remember in the last class, okay, I have told you ki pi bond kaisa lagta. So if you haven't seen my previous classes of GOC, please watch them. I have told you over there that initially this is the, these are the p orbitals. Yeah, finally when you look at the picture, ye sigma bond bana deta hu main. Finally when you look at the bonded picture of the pi bond, yes. So these two join in a bonding fashion, constructive overlap, and iske sir pe bhi ek aisa lobe sa ban jayega, iske niche bhi ek aisa lobe sa ban jayega. So essentially what's happening is, this carbon-carbon single bond is now restricted in rotation by these two things happening on top and bottom. Ye dekh lo aise karke. Theek hai? So maan lo, ye jo hai mere fingers, my thumbs touching together and my fingers touching together, these are your pi bonding clouds. Okay, so iski wajah se rotation is not possible. Yeah, as you can see, they can't rotate. Ye fix ho gaya ab. Yes, because of this, what happens is, we see the phenomena of geometrical isomerism. So sabse simple example lenge shuru mein. Let's think about this. This is what this guy over here is called, transbutuene. Apan cis-trans pe aate hain bahut hi jaldi. And the other isomer possible for this case is cis-trans 2-butene. Okay, so ho kya raha hai yahan pe? CH3 and CH3 are on the opposite ends. Yes, so ye hamara ho gaya trans, and this guy over here is cis. Understand the difference between these two structures. I'll tell you a very good trick right now that will always help you recognize whether something can show geometrical isomerism or not, whether geometrical isomers exist or not for that structure. I'll tell you. See, if I have to fit this cis in some place, let's say yes, cis is like a building block. Wo puzzles khele honge na, when you have to place a certain block into the same shape. Bachpan mein kabhi khela hoga ya. So imagine that this is a playing block. Aise tumhare haath mein cis hai. To maan lo ki, you know, let's say you have something like this in your hand. Let's say this is a toy that you hand and you have to place it somewhere. So where can I place it? I can place it in a box that looks like this. Yeah, कुछ ऐसा होगा तो मैं यहां जाके आराम से इसको रख दूंगा. Yes, it fits perfectly. Yeah, ठीक है जी, fine. So now I can't rotate this. So this remains like this and hence it will fit in this particular block. Now look at this case. Okay, अब इस केस में what is the template that I have to make? This is the template. कैसा template बनेगा इस केस में? इस केस में template बनेगा ऐसा. Now see what will happen. कुछ ऐसा रहेगा scene. Yeah, I can't rotate this. Ye to phasa hua hai yahan pe. So this can easily fit into this template that I've made. This is the way to understand whether two things are isomers or not. Can they fit the same template? If they can, then they are not isomers. If they can't fit the same template, then they definitely are isomers. Okay, geometrical case mein, to visualize that is absolutely simple. So do you understand how these are isomers? Both of them are butuene, yes, but one of them can fit in this template, one of them can fit in this template. Now, what's happening is CH3 on one side, CH3 on the other side, yeah? CH3 on the opposite ends. So, upon use karenge trans. Yes, I think it's a Latin word that means across, yeah? And then you have cis, which means that both of the groups, both of the CH3 groups, these are methyl groups, yes? Both of them are on the same side. Yes, now you must be wondering, sir, what cases actually show geometrical isomerism? See, I'll show you cases that do not show geometrical isomerism. For example, can this show geometrical isomerism? Let's try to figure it out. Okay, so ho kya raha hai ki yahan pe to mere paas, I have just hydrogens, yes? Dono hydrogen same hai. Both of the hydrogens are same. Over here I have C2H5 and I have a CH3 group. Yes, let's try to do one thing. Okay, kya karte hai? Let's try to exchange the places of these two in the structure that I'll make. So apan kya karte hai? Isko aise banayenge. Ye double bond hai beech mein. Upar methyl le aaya main and niche maine bana diya C2H5. Yes, I've just swapped the places and then hydrogens are still the same. ठीक है, so hydrogens are really tiny. Let's not even bother about them. इनको भूल जाते हैं अभी के लिए, okay? Because they are really tiny, so we don't really need to worry about them. Plus, both of those things were the same itself. Now let's try to make a template for that. इसके template कैसे बनेगा? इसका template बनेगा something like this. Yes, I can easily fit that over there into that template. Okay, always imagine a template in your mind. Let's make a template for this guy. ये template है. ऐसे 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 और ये यहाँ पे ऐसा. This will be the template. उसको पकड़ के यहाँ fit कर सकते हो. This is what it looks like. Yes, ऐसे करके दिखेगा. अब चक्कर ये है. I can rotate the molecule like this, isn't it? I haven't changed any bond. All I have done is I've rotated the entire molecule. So this guy could fit over here, but the same guy can fit over here as well. So can these two show geometrical isomerism? No, they are in fact the same structure, yes? All you have to do is take it out of the plane. यहां भी रख सकते हो, यहां भी रख सकते हो. So the idea is, when can you see geometrical isomerism? This is the center of restricted rotation, also known as a stereo center, because we are talking about stereoisomerism. Okay, this is the stereo center of restricted rotation. Now, एक ना बीच में ऐसे लाइन खींचो, make a dotted line like this. This is A, this is B, this is C, this is D. Geometrical isomerism is possible when
तभी हो सकता है जब A is not equal to B and C is not equal to D. You must be saying, sir, what about this case? Will this show geometrical isomerism? Yes, it will. Because on the left-hand side, both things are different. On the right-hand side, both things are different. You have to see just the left side, both things are different. Okay? You have to see just the right side, both things are different. Okay, awesome. It can show geometrical isomerism. This will not show geometrical isomerism. Yes, because yahan pe dono cheeze same hai. Exactly. On the left hand side, both of the things are same. On the right hand side, both are different. Okay, fine. Then let's look at another case. Can you see substituents on the right hand side are the same as the left hand side? But if I look just at the right hand side, I have a C2H5 and a hydrogen. Both are different from each other. Left hand side will be C2H5 hydrogen. Both are different from each other. Hence, yes, this shows geometrical isomerism. Theek hai ji? Samka na? Let's take a case where everything is different. Let's take this case, yeah? यहाँ पे बड़ा सा ग्रुप लगा दिया, प्रोपाइल लगा दिया मैंने, यहाँ पे इथाइल है, यहाँ पे मिथाइल है, yes, and over here there's a hydrogen. Everything is different, of course it will show geometrical isomerism. So what I'm trying to do is, I'm trying to teach you geometrical isomerism in a fashion that it becomes super logical for you to understand it. There is no formula behind how to see geometrical isomers. They just exist the way they do, yes? Now I'll show you a few more cases where restricted rotation can happen and then we'll see a lot of examples. So, pehle toh kya karte hai restricted rotation mein? Sabse simple case toh hai C double bond C, yes? Ek second pen uthane do. C double bond C, this is a case. Very simple. Another case of restricted rotation that is really interesting is N double bond N. Okay. N double bond N be restricted center ho sakta. We'll see examples of this. And the most interesting restricted rotation point is, and you'll be saying, sir, ye kya bana rahe ho? Benzene bana rahe ho kya? No, I'm making a cyclohexane. ओके ये पूरा एक 6 मेंबर्ड का रिंग है. नाउ यू मस्ट बी सेइंग सर हाउ कैन दिस बी रिस्ट्रिक्टेड रोटेशन. ओके लेट मी ट्राई टू मेक यू इमेजिन दैट. लेट्स से ओवर हियर यू हैव अ CH3 एंड लेट्स से ओवर हियर एज वेल यू हैव लेट्स से अ C2H5. कुछ भी बना लो अभी, ठीक है. नाउ दीज कार्बन्स दैट यू नोटिस, व्हाट इज द वैलेंसी ऑफ दीज कार्बन्स? These carbons have a valency of 4, of course. So, 3 bonds I've already made. What's the last bond that I've not made? That's going to be hydrogen, for obvious reasons. Now, people, what did I say? Why does geometrical isomerism not happen in a single bond? Because it is free to rotate. So, single bond, if I make this situation, CH3, this is my C2H5. And instead of the ring, now I've made just two methyl groups over there. Now, can you see that this can easily rotate? Yeah, ऐसे ऐसे घूमता रहेगा ये, तो कोई geometrical isomerism नहीं होगा. Now what has happened is, this entire thing is joined like a ring. Okay, पहले ये खुला हुआ था, but I have joined it like a ring. So imagine my hands touching together like a ring. Okay, अब rotate हो सकता है ये? नहीं. Can you see it can't rotate? Yes. So since this can't rotate anymore because you've joined these carbons together, this case also exists for restricted rotation. Yes, iska ulta isomer banayenge apan to. Let's make the geometrical isomer of this. Iska geometrical isomer aisa hoga. Okay, ye CH3 upar aa gaya, the hydrogen goes over here, C2H5 remains over here and hydrogen comes over here. So basically just flip one of the carbons, so ban gaye na dono. Yes, as simple as that. So both of these are geometrical isomers of each other. Restricted rotation, wherever you see this guy, wherever you can see rotation being restricted. So kahan kahan ho gaya? Ek double bond ke case mein ho gaya. Yeah, this is the pi bonding cloud. Same case is happening with nitrogen. And you can form a ring as well. Ye sigma bond was able to rotate easily. Now you fixed it because of the ring. Yes. So now people, what I'll tell you is, let's talk about cis-trans isomerism. ठीक है, cis-trans अभी मैंने बताया तुम्हें. So CH3 and CH3 on the opposite sides. This is trans. बहुत ही सिंपल है ये trans. इसका cis बनाना है मुझे, तो कैसे बनाऊंगा? Make both the CH3 on the same side. Yeah, बन गया. This guy is going to be my cis. This is going to be trans. Now one thing is,
when do you use cis-trans nomenclature? Okay, I'm sure you must have heard, sir, there is sin-anti, there is easy. When do I use cis-trans? Yes, that's the case. Cis-trans apan tab use karenge when on either side of the double bond there are two hydrogens. What it means is there are just two substituents. Okay, I can't use cis-trans nomenclature in this case. Yeah, CH3, CH3, C2H5, propyl. So the point is, over here I can't use cis-trans isomerism technically speaking. I can use cis-trans isomerism only when these groups are hydrogens. So I can easily say that the substituents, okay, this substituent and this substituent are cis to each other or trans to each other. Okay, you must be saying, sir, but if both of them are CH3, then also we can say. Technically you can't. That's how the nomenclature has been designed. Okay, so tum is case mein cis-trans bol sakte ho. It is possible to say cis-trans because both substituents are on the same side. But you can't say cis-trans in case of this. Jaise hi ye kar diya na. Now what I do? Do I say it's cis of iodine with respect to chlorine or iodine with respect to bromine is trans? What do? So that will be done when we talk about EZ isomerism, which will be in a couple of slides. Okay, so cis-trans ke kuch aur cases dekhte hain. Let's just quickly see the cases of cis-trans so that you know where they exist. Look at these cases. Ye dekho. Cyclohexane, I told you, a restricted rotation. So this is the bond. So this is my trans. Yeah. Well, how will you name this? You will name this trans 1,2 dimethyl cyclohexane. Trans 1,2 dimethyl cyclohexane. Let's look at this case. Again, ring ho gaya, restricted rotation. CH3s are both on the same side. So this becomes cis. Cis 1,2 dimethyl cyclopropane. As simple as that. Okay, so trans ho gaya, cis ho gaya. Now these cases need not be just between the two subsequent carbons of a ring. Let's take this case. Ye case bana lo aap. Okay, let's say there is a CH3 here, there is a CH3 here. These black lines are CH3s. You must be saying, sir, ye bahut dur ho gaya. Yes, I agree. But do you understand that there is still restricted rotation? Bond thoda bada ho gaya, but again the ring can't rotate itself, right? Hai na? Wo pura palat ke aise nahi ja payega. So this, once again, is a trans case. How will you name it? Trans 1,3. Yes, 1,2, fir 3. So this is trans 1,3 dimethyl cyclohexane. Okay, so cis trans need not only exist in the two consecutive carbons of a ring, it can exist anywhere connecting two things from a ring. Theek hai ji, chalo aage badhenge thoda sa. Let's see this case. Cool, isko main thoda sa fancy tarike se banata hu. So imagine that this square, okay, this cyclobutane is lying on your table. Okay, so maan lo ki ye jo kitab hai, this book is your cyclobutane. So I have kept it like this on the desk itself. Let's try to draw it on paper. Okay, so ye carbon hai, ye carbon hai. Now I am trying to draw it like a diamond. Okay, aisa tha. Yes, this is what it is. I am trying to draw it like this. Got it? So chalo banate hain. ऐसा कुछ बनेगा. ये कार्बन पीछे जा रहा है. सो दोनों कार्बन से बॉन्ड पीछे जा रहे हैं. यस, एंड दोनों कार्बन से एक एक बॉन्ड आगे भी आएगा ये वाले कार्बन पे. डू यू अंडरस्टैंड दिस आइडिया? आई एम श्योर यू डू. या दीज सॉलिड वेजेस आर कमिंग टुवर्ड्स यू, दीज डॉटेड वेजेस आर गोइंग बिहाइंड. बन गया ना ऐसे, ये ऐसे रखा हुआ है. या नाउ यू कैन सी दिस CH3, लेट्स से इज ऑन द टॉप. This CH3 is on the bottom. What have we not made? We have just implicitly thought about hydrogens. Yeah. So this guy is my trans 1,3 dimethyl cyclobutane. Yes. Similarly, iska cis bhi bana sakta hu main. Cis karna to kya karenge? Chupchap se utha ke CH3 H. Now this guy becomes cis. As simple as that. Cis-trans mein koi dikkat nahi hai. The only thing is the restricted rotation center should have two hydrogens around it. Theek hai, taki main substituent ko irrespectively bol sakun ek dusre ke hisab se. Yeah, that's the idea. So now let's look at these cases. Achha. What is the restricted rotation over here? Ye thoda fancy case hai. Yes, let's try to see. So what is the restricted rotation over here? I'll tell you. This guy over here is the restricted rotation. Theek hai? This is one of the groups. This is one of the groups. One of it is hydrogen. One of it is hydrogen. In this example, we are looking at this double bond that will serve as the restricted rotation center over here. Yeah, because alag se substituents to nahi hai na yahan pe. Now people, can this exist in a trans form? Okay, around this double bond, this is cis. I totally agree with you. This red bond on same side, red bond on the same side, two hydrogens. So this, according to this double bond, is cis. Can the transform exist? Okay. So transform kaisa hoga? Aise, aise. Oh, phir tum jodoge kaise? There are one and two carbons. Yes. Will you join it like this? On paper, it is easy to draw. But in reality, what happens is this ring is very small. Yes. Choti si ring hogi, 6 carbon hai. Now if there is 6 carbons in the ring, it is not easy for it to bend around like this in order to form a trans case. So for smaller rings, okay, for rings of size less than equal to 7, such cases cannot show cis-trans isomerism. Such cases cannot show geometrical isomerism. This does not exist. For rings of size less than or equal to 7. If we go to a ring of size 8, now let's see this double bond. Ye hai mera center of rotation. This is one group. The other two groups that I'm not drawing are hydrogens. Now these two groups, let's try to draw the transform of it. And that is really entertaining when you look at it, okay? Ye banaya, ye aur ye. Ab ho gaya trans, yahan pe ye cis tha. Yeah. This is cis cyclooctene. ठीक है ना, अब अपन बनाएंगे ट्रांस साइक्लोक्टीन. कैसे बनाएंगे? आई विल शो यू हाउ इट इज मेड ऑन पेपर. ओके, एंड आई विल शो यू थ्रू अ विजुअलाइजेशन एज वेल कि वो दिखता कैसे है. ठीक है, अपने पास कितने बन गए? 1, 2, 3, 4 कार्बन बन गए. वी नीड 4 मोर कार्बन. लेट्स पुट दोज 4 कार्बन लाइक दिस. अब सर ये क्या है? ये कुछ ऐसा है दोस्तों, ये है, ये है, ये है और ये है. एंड नाउ दीज टू बॉन्ड्स दैट आई हैव टू ज्वाइन, इमेजिन दैट दे आर बिहाइंड द डबल बॉन्ड. ओके, पूरा ये रिंग है और ये पीछे से ऐसे जुड़ा हुआ है. ओके, आई एम मेकिंग इट डॉटेड बिकॉज दिस इज बिहाइंड द डबल बॉन्ड. ओके, दिस इज माय ट्रांस साइक्लोक्टीन. नाउ यू मस्ट बी सेइंग सर ये कुछ चमका नहीं, कैन यू हेल्प अस विजुअलाइज this somehow. Okay, imagine that this is your double bond, this is your restricted rotation center, and imagine that this string that I have, I hope you're able to see it in the camera, this is your 8-membered ring. So theek hai, ye pura string jo hai, ye 8-membered ring hai, and these two carbons are of the restricted double bond. Theek hai, aise gaya aur piche se aise aake jud gaya. Okay, so something like this. Can you see? एक साइड पे ये ऊपर जा रहा है, एक साइड पे ये नीचे आ रहा है. Yes. So this makes it trans. That is what it looks like. Okay. ये जो मैं बना रहा हूं ना यहां पे, this is what I've made over here. Okay. ये जो पूरा रिंग है ये ऐसे जा रहा है. Got it? Now this is possible only because the ring is super huge. It has a lot of flexibility. I am sure you remember in the previous class as well, I told you, yeah, if you want to join your hands and make a small circle, it is easily possible. But if the whole class of 50 people is trying to make a circle by joining their hands, then it never becomes a circle. Remember your physical education periods. Similarly over here, it has a lot of flexibility and it can bend itself around in order to do this. Okay? So trans is not possible in this case, it is possible in this case. Cool? बढ़िया, चलो आगे बढ़ेंगे थोड़ा. नाउ लेट अस लुक एट सिन एंटी. ठीक है, सो सिन एंटी क्या है? इट्स जस्ट अनदर वे ऑफ राइटिंग आइसोमेरिज्म, एंड दिस इज यूज्ड इन केसेस वेयर एवर माय नाइट्रोजन इज इन्वॉल्वड. ओके, सो व्हेन नाइट्रोजन इज इन्वॉल्वड, आई एम श्योर यू कैन सी, ओके, दैट इन दिस स्ट्रक्चर देर इज अ लोन पेयर, देर इज एन OH, देर इज अ CH3, देर इज अ हाइड्रोजन. यस, नाउ आई एम श्योर यू कैन सी कि अगर मैं इसको ऐसे बना दूं. Yeah, this is my CH3, this is my double bond, this is nitrogen, यहाँ पे लोन पेयर ले आता हूँ एंड आई विल राइट माय OH ओवर देयर. या दिस इज योर CH3 एंड दिस इज योर हाइड्रोजन. कूल. कैन यू सी बोथ द स्ट्रक्चर्स आर डिफरेंट. या यू कैन ऑल्सो यूज द टेम्पलेट मेथड इफ यू विश टू. ओके, इसका टेम्पलेट कैसा बनाओगे? टू मेक टेम्पलेट, फॉरगेट अबाउट हाइड्रोजन. ओके, सो इसका टेम्पलेट कुछ ऐसा बनेगा. यू वुड वॉन्ट टू मेक समथिंग लाइक दिस फॉर द लोन पेयर. Okay, so this is your template that you have to fit it in. Can you fit that structure over here in this template? This can fit the template, that over here cannot. Flip karke dekh lo, OH yahan ghusega to CH3 niche chala jayega. Now how do we name them? Can we call them cis and trans? Well, scientists decided that cis and trans should be used only for carbon substituents generally. So when you have nitrogen in the restricted rotation center, then we'll use something called syn and anti-isomerism. Theek hai? So syn and anti kaise karenge people? This kind of a structure is known as an aldoxime. Jo log 12th mein hai, droppers hai, they would know. Whoever is in 11th, you will study this very soon when you talk about the chapter of carbonyl compounds. Okay? What you have to see in aldoxymes, okay? Aldoxymes mein there is a CH3, there is an H. So basically this comes out of, okay, ye aisa tha pehle. Okay, this was my aldehyde. I have replaced this oxygen with that nitrogen, hence aldoxime. So in an aldoxime, on the left hand side or wherever you have the carbon, you will have a कार्बन चेन एंड देन यू विल हैव अ हाइड्रोजन. यस, एल्डिहाइड में यही होता ना, एक हाइड्रोजन बाकी कार्बन चेन. सो नाउ व्हाट विल हैपन ओवर हियर, यू हैव टू सी द रिलेटिव पोजीशन ऑफ OH विद रिस्पेक्ट टू द हाइड्रोजन. दिस इज अ कंफ्यूजिंग केस, सो प्लीज लिसन टू इट केयरफुली. यू हैव टू सी द रिलेटिव ओरिएंटेशन ऑफ OH विद रिस्पेक्ट टू हाइड्रोजन. ओके, सो दिस गाय ओवर हियर इज अ सिन एल्डोक्साइन. ओके, दिस गाय ओवर हियर ऑक्सीजन यहां पे है, हाइड्रोजन यहां पे है, ऑपोजिट टू ईच अदर, हेंस आई विल कॉल देम एंटी एल्डोक्साइम. इन द केस ऑफ एल्डोक्साइम एंड ओनली एल्डोक्साइम यू हैव टू सी OH एंड H. ठीक है, अपन जनरली क्या करते हैं, ग्रुप्स देखते हैं ना, हाइड्रोजन को भूल जाते हैं, CH3OH देखे हो सेम साइड से. नो, aldoxime follows a very specific type of nomenclature. This aldoxime is syn, this aldoxime is anti, because you see the relative position of OH with H. Theek hai, is cheez ko yaad rakhna. Now what if I have a ketoxime? Okay, instead of this aldoxime, let's turn it into a ketoxime. Ketoxime mein kaise banaunga main bhai, isko kar do C2H5. Ketoxime ho gaya. How ketoxime? Because this originated from this kind of a species. This is a ketone. So ketone se aayega to ketoxime. Now what will we do in ketoxime? See, ketoxime mein things become a little more tricky. Okay. This OH and this is what? This is my ethyl group. This is my methyl group. Yeah. How will I write what this ketoxime is? I will write that this is syn ethyl methyl ketoxime. Syn ke saath maine laga diya ethyl. Another way I can describe this ketoxime is I can also call it anti methyl ethyl jo bhi hai. Ketoxime. The point is, this ketoxime is anti for methyl, OH or CH3 anti, and this is syn for ethyl. So you can use both of these descriptors in order to tell about this particular isomer. Yes, iska geometrical isomer banayenge. Ye ho gaya iska geometrical isomer. Ek second. यहां पे रहा लोन पेयर और यहां पे आ गया OH. दिस इज द ज्योमेट्रिकल आइसोमर, इजंट इट, है ना. अब ये क्या है, दिस इज एंटी इथाइल, यस, एंड दिस इज सिन मिथाइल, बिकॉज OH और CH3 सेम साइड पे है, OH एंड इथाइल आर ऑन द ऑपोजिट एंड्स. सो दिस इज हाउ सिन एंटी वर्क्स इन द केस ऑफ कीटोक्साइम्स. ओके, इंटरेस्टिंग है ना. पर ये कोई ज्यादा पूछेगा नहीं, नो वन इज गोना आस्क यू टू मच अबाउट दिस केस. आई जस्ट टोल्ड यू फॉर द इन्फॉर्मेशन सेक, सो जस्ट कीप इट इन योर माइंड, इट्स नॉट दैट हार्ड टू अंडरस्टैंड. ठीक है, देन वी माइट हैव दीज केसेस, ओके, डाइएजिनाइल केसेस, एजो कंपाउंड्स. इफ यू गूगल फॉर एजो कंपाउंड्स, ऐसे कंपाउंड्स दिख जाएंगे तुम्हें. सो क्या है, एन डबल बॉन्ड एन. या नाउ दिस केस इज वेरी सिंपल, दिस केस इज वेरी सिंपल, लोन पेयर्स ऑन द ऑपोजिट साइड्स. ठीक है, इसको देखना बहुत सिंपल है. लोन पेयर्स ऑन द ऑपोजिट साइड्स, दिस इज एंटी, दिख रहा है ऑपोजिट साइड्स. या मेक लोन पेयर्स ऑन द सेम साइड्स, यहां पे बना लो, दिस इज योर मिथाइल, दिस इज मिथाइल इथाइल, दिस विल बिकम सिन. एजिनाइल कंपाउंड्स, ओके, एजिनाइल बोले तो देयर इज अ एन डबल बॉन्ड एन इनसाइड द स्ट्रक्चर. ठीक है, सो एजिनाइल कंपाउंड्स के लिए सिन एंटी वर्क्स लाइक दिस. सो सिस ट्रांस कर लिया अपन ने, जहां कार्बन कार्बन डबल बॉन्ड था एंड देयर वाज टू सब्स्टिट्यूएंट्स, देयर वर टू सब्स्टिट्यूएंट्स और दो चीजें हाइड्रोजन थी, दैट वाज सिस ट्रांस. सिन एंटी कहां पे आया, वेयर एवर देयर इज एन डबल बॉन्ड. एंड नाउ वी विल कम टू समथिंग दैट इज इवन मोर इंटरेस्टिंग एंड दैट इज एंटिगेगेन-ज़ुसमैन आइसोमेरिज्म. Essentially, it is just geometrical isomerism. It is just a way to depict isomerism in absolute terms. Absolute bole to see. First, let's understand what is relative. This was trans, yes? Because this methyl group is trans relative to this methyl group, yes? So, relatively, we could decide this ethyl group is trans to this methyl group relatively because others were hydrogen. Okay, so since we had only two groups relative to each other, we could easily say cis or trans. Over here now, four groups. Will I say fluorine, chlorine, cis, fluorine, iodine, anti, chlorine, bromine, trans, chlorine, fluorine, syn? Will I do all of that in one name? No, right? That just doesn't make sense. Because I'll have to tell you the relative orientation of all of these four things. Yes? Imagine you are standing in front of your friend. So you can say, my friend is behind me. Okay, fine. Imagine that three friends are standing behind you. How will you tell whether they are standing in a straight line or whether they are standing at an angle with you? It becomes difficult as you increase the number of people standing with respect to each other. Yes. So, in this case, maybe we follow something called easy isomers. What we do is we will give priorities to these substituents. Okay, priority denge. So let's say this has first priority over here. Let's say this has first priority over here. I'll teach you how to give priority. So since this is on the same side, high priority groups on the same side, I will call it Z isomer, Zusammen. So entgegen, Zusammen are essentially German words. Entgegen means opposite, Zusammen means same. You must be saying, sir, this is one place which confuses me a lot. Is there a trick to remember it? I'll give you a very pathetic yet useful trick to remember entgegen-Zusammen kaisa hota hai, okay? Remember this. Remember same and opposite. Remember this and you'll remember it for the rest of your life, okay? Same. It is on the same side. Yeah, so same and opposite. So E is in case the same priority groups are on the opposite sides. Z is in case the same priority groups are on the same side. So cis-trans, maybe you can use easy isomers. So cis-trans isomers are like a subset of easy isomerism. Yeah. So maan lo ye hai aisa structure. This is trans-butuene. Yes. Instead of calling it trans-butuene, you can also call it E-butuene. Because are on the opposite sides. Okay, cis ko tum bol sakte ho Z. Theek hai? So this is similar to cis. This guy is similar to trans. Okay, same opposite helps. Now let us understand how to decide the priority order. Bhai sahab itna bakwas kar liya, iska priority to batao. I'll tell you now. And then comes one of my favorite things in geometrical isomerism, and that is Cahn-Ingold-Prelog sequencing rules, and this is also called CIP, of course, for Cahn-Ingold-Prelog. I think these were Russian scientists as far as I remember. So these are their surnames. Three scientists worked on these priority rules. They are just conventional, okay? Ek apan ne standard bana diya just to see what is the relative orientation of the groups. Now CIP rules are important because these are used a lot in optical isomerism as well. Optical isomerism ke sawal har saal aate hain JEE mein. So now let's try to understand what is Cahn-Ingold-Prelog rules. Okay. First of all, you have to decide by atomic number. First priority is for atomic number. Then let's say you hit isotopes. Okay. So maan lo ki double bond C hai. On one side I have to decide between the priority of these two groups. Let's say A and B. Aur ya laga lo tum bromine and argon. Ya thoda aur simple laga lete hain. Bromine and chlorine laga lo. Chalo. Yeah. So bromine and chlorine. So over here I can easily decide atomic number is higher for bromine. So this gets the higher priority. So just to mark higher priority, I have put a circle around it and put a tick mark. Yeah, this has higher priority. Okay, awesome. What if I have this case now? Okay, let's say I have hydrogen versus deuterium. Ab kya karenge? Now we look at the mass number because atomic number is the same. So atomic mass dekhenge apan. Aur in dono mein se iska atomic mass zyada rehta hai, of course, because it has one extra neutron. This becomes your higher priority case. Then what is this? Same on first, then go to the next. I'll tell you what I mean by that. Let's say on this carbon there is CH3. On this carbon there is CH2, CH3. Okay, I'll draw this in a different manner so that we can understand this third point even better. CH3 ki jagah main aise banata hu isko, hydrogen, hydrogen, hydrogen. Okay, aur iske paas kya hai? Hydrogen, hydrogen and then carbon with another CH3 on it. Yes. Ab kya hua? When I go to the carbons itself, both of them are same carbons, both of them same mass number, atomic number, everything. So then we'll go to the next step. Okay. Agar same on first hai, these are both the same. So let's go on the next step. Now in the next step, hydrogen, hydrogen, still the same. Hydrogen, hydrogen, still the same. Hydrogen versus carbon. So this guy gets more priority, eventually giving this whole group more priority. Okay, so agar maan lo tumhare paas ye carbon hai with one methyl and one ethyl group, the ethyl will get more priority. This is pretty obvious, I'm sure. Yeah, so ab main iske liye thoda sa sawal karte hain. Yeah, let's try to see the what kind of an isomer is this. Okay, chlorine. And let's say OH. Let's say somehow you are able to synthesize this compound in the laboratory. Let's try to decide what is it. Is it E or is it Z? Yeah, ye sochte hain E hai ya Z hai. Toh dekho. On the left hand side, okay, divide things into left hand side, right hand side. Left hand side mein, which of these is higher priority? Oxygen versus chlorine. Chlorine has higher atomic number. Chlorine. Baat hi khatam. Now on the right hand side, bromine versus iodine. What do we do? Iodine has higher atomic number. Higher priority groups on the same side. What do we call this? Zame. Yes, this is your Z. Zeumain isomer. Okay. Iska E isomer bhi bana dete hain fatafat se. E isomer mein just flip one of the places. So iodine bromine ko aise hi rehne dete hain. Yahan pe upar OH le aaya main, yahan pe chlorine. Theek hai. So now same priority groups are on the opposite sides. This is opposite. Entgegen. Yeah, so Zeme, opposite, Zeumain, Entgegen. These are just German words. So if you perhaps have a German dictionary or if you know German, then you should start teaching German to people because that will give you a lot of money. Anyway, so now the interesting case comes. Okay, interesting case mein kya dekhenge? This is the double bond C. Okay, so right hand side bana raha hu main. Let's say there's a C triple bond N on top of it and there's a carbon over here. Okay, which has a nitrogen on it, which has another nitrogen on it. Okay, and let's say it has another OH group on it, let's say. Very weird structure. Yeah, isko zyada priority do ya isko zyada priority do. Now people, you have to understand. Okay, I have to interpret this in a better manner. Let's see how to interpret that. Look at the interpretation carefully. It is literally the most fun part about CIP rules. Hardly anyone asks question on this, but still I'm going to tell you because it is entertaining. C triple bond N. Is carbon ko dekho dhyan se. What is this carbon? This carbon is bonded to nitrogen 3 times. In order to decide the CIP rules, in order to decide the CIP priority, how will I interpret this? Make this carbon. Theek hai, bana diya ye carbon. Ab iske saath 3 nitrogen ke bonds. It has 3 bonds with nitrogen. Do what? Do 3 bonds with nitrogen separately. अब बोलोगे ये क्या कर दिया सर, हाउ इज दैट पॉसिबल? वी आर डूइंग दिस जस्ट फॉर द सेक ऑफ आर इमेजिनेशन सो दैट वी कैन गिव अ गुड प्रायोरिटी. ठीक है, सो व्हाट हैज हैपेंड, कार्बन इज बॉन्डेड टू थ्री नाइट्रोजन्स, थ्री बॉन्ड्स विद नाइट्रोजन, थ्री नाइट्रोजन्स. नाउ लेट्स से दैट दिस नाइट्रोजन, द फर्स्ट वन इज द रियल नाइट्रोजन. ओके, सो दिस इज रियल एंड दिस इज ऑल्सो रियल. अदर टू आर फेक नाइट्रोजन्स दैट यू हैव ड्रॉन फ्रॉम योर इमेजिनेशन, सो उनको अपन ब्रैकेट में बंद कर देते हैं. Yeah, these two are fake nitrogens. Now, what is the real nitrogen bonded to? The real nitrogen, look at the real nitrogen. The real nitrogen is bonded to carbon atom thrice. Three nitrogen to carbon bonds. Let's make those over here. Carbon, carbon, carbon. Will I do that? No. Because one carbon with nitrogen bond is already made over here. So, do bache the na? Isko hata dete hain apan yahan se. Yeah. So what will we have over here? These two. So this is my real carbon bonded to three nitrogens because triple bond. One of the nitrogens is real, other two nitrogen are fake. अपन ने बना दिए खुद से. Yes, this real one exists. The real one has a single bond with this carbon. ये अपना black वाला, ये वाला bond रहा, ठीक है? And then it has two pi bonds with this carbon as well. Two fake carbons are necessary to show that. और ये ऐसे बन जाएगा. ठीक है, राइट दिस डाउन, आई विल शो यू अनदर एग्जांपल. लेट्स लुक एट दिस केस. ओके, इफ यू वांट टू रिवाइंड इट यू कैन इजीली रिवाइंड इट, वीडियो है, कोई चक्कर नहीं. सो लेट्स थिंक अबाउट दिस सब्स्टिट्यूएंट. ओके, सी डबल बॉन्ड ओ, मान लो ऐसा है, सी डबल बॉन्ड ओ, एच लगा इस पे. सो व्हाट इज दिस? दिस इज अ कार्बन जिसपे एक ऑक्सीजन का बॉन्ड, दो ऑक्सीजन का बॉन्ड और एक हाइड्रोजन का बॉन्ड. Now one of the oxygens is fake because you just made it fugazi. Fugazi means fake. So now, ye oxygen jo hai, this is the real oxygen. Yeah, this guy and this guy, these are the real ones. So this has one bond with carbon which is already over here. So let's make the other bond with carbon as well over here in the next level. And this carbon is also imaginary. So bracket mein apan ne bana diye are fake carbons, are imaginary carbons. Theek hai? So is tarah se we can decipher these. Now let's try to understand this case. Okay, iski priority order decide karne ke liye let's try to understand. So carbon triple bond nitrogen ko kaise banayenge? Three nitrogens ke sath bonds, nitrogen nitrogen, these are fake, and this nitrogen has two more carbons, both of them are fake. Now let us make the carbon on the bottom. Ye bana carbon, then you have nitrogen with two hydrogens. ठीक है, then you have another nitrogen with two hydrogens, and then you have an OH. ठीक है जी, how will we decide now? The first one is carbon itself, so carbon carbon no priority. Then let's look at this case, nitrogen nitrogen cancel कर दिया एक दूसरे को, another nitrogen cancel कर दिया एक दूसरे को. This is a fake nitrogen and this is an oxygen. Fake को भी अपन fake नहीं बोलेंगे. This is a nitrogen, this is an oxygen. So oxygen has more priority, isn't it? Yes, oxygen की ज़्यादा priority रहेगी. So this guy over here gets more priority. ये जो पूरा group है ना, ये ज़्यादा priority ले जाएगा. Okay, so let's say on this side I have something like this. Okay, यहाँ पे hydrogen. So what is this? High priority group is CH3, hydrogen से CH3 ज्यादा रहेगा. So this is my entailed isomer E. ठीक है, इसको और complicated करूं थोड़ा, चलो let's make it even more complicated. This is entertaining, मतलब ये समझ आ गया, JEE advanced geometrical isomer हलवा. Okay, so C ये वाला था, यहां पे C triple bond N है, and then there is carbon which has NH2 and NH2. Oh, अब क्या करें? Now what do we do? Let's see. उसको बनाते हैं पहले, ठीक है? So ये carbon, nitrogen, fugazi nitrogen, and another fugazi nitrogen. ठीक है? बहुत मजा आ रहा है मुझे तो. I hope you are also enjoying. And इस nitrogen पे I'll make two carbon bonds. I will not bond the fake things with anything else. Fake things will have only one bond because they are fake. This is what I have for C triple bond N. Let's make this guy. Carbon, nitrogen, nitrogen, nitrogen. And these nitrogens both have
hydrogen. All of these nitrogens have two hydrogens each. Yes, hydrogen and hydrogen.
Cool. अब देखो दोस्तों, चल क्या रहा है यहाँ पे? First level में there is no choice. Second level में nitrogen, no choice over here as well. काट दो. Let's look at this case. Carbon, hydrogen. So, first level पे भी काम नहीं हुआ, second पे भी नहीं हुआ. We went to the third level to understand what's going on, and hence carbon gets more priority over hydrogen, and this guy over here now becomes higher priority. Yeah. So similarly, if you have a carbon over here which has a CH3 and H, what is this now? This is your zeeemain. Yes, Z isomer. Cahn-Ingold-Prelog rules. Cahn-Ingold-Prelog rules. Really, really simple. Yes. Chalo ji. Bahut kar liya Cahn-Ingold-Prelog. If you practice more, you will get better. So, jo PDF dala maine wo dekh lena dosto. Chalo. Now we'll come to total number of isomers. Ye bataunga main fatafat se, and then we'll do questions on the same. Yes. So total number of isomers ka kya matlab hai? Let's say there are more than one stereo center, more than one geometrical center inside your structure. So laga lo ye aisa hai, theek hai? Ye ek bond aur ye ek aisa. Theek hai? Now this guy, you know how the other isomers will look like? I'll give you a glimpse of it. Let's say this guy exists in its cis form, aur dusra wala bhai sahab jo hai, wo trans hi exist karta hai. Yeah, so this bond is cis, this bond is trans over here, this is trans. Yes. Ho sakta hai dono cis ho jaye kisi tarah. Both of the bonds are now cis. Can you see all of these are isomers of each other? ठीक है, तो यहां पे मैं लिखूंगा, आई विल जस्ट राइट इजी फॉर द सेक ऑफ सिंपलिसिटी. सो दिस इज अपोजिट, दिस इज ऑल्सो अपोजिट. या दिस इज व्हाट, दिस इज जेम, दिस इज अपोजिट, दिस इज व्हाट, दिस इज जेम एंड जेम. या सो ई जी इस तरह के आइसोमर बन सकते हैं. यस. सो नाउ द आइडिया इज लेट्स ट्राई टू काउंट द टोटल नंबर ऑफ आइसोमर्स. तो एक बनाते हैं बड़ा अच्छा सा केस. मान लो ये है अपने पास डबल बॉन्ड एंड देयर इज अ ब्रोमीन. ओके, सो व्हाट विल बी द केसेस? इजी या मतलब इजी, जीई, जीजीईई, चार केसेस हो सकते हैं. सो आई एम श्योर ओवर हियर यू कैन सिंपली काउंट, देयर विल बी फोर केसेस. इंस्टेड लेट्स ट्राई टू थिंक ऑफ अ फॉर्मुलेशन ओवर हियर. नो वन्स रियली गोना आस्क यू दिस, बट इफ यू वांट टू रिमेंबर द फॉर्मूला यू कैन. देयर आर टू सेंटर्स ओवर हियर, टू डबल बॉन्ड्स. Where N is the number of double bonds. 2 raised to the power N. आ गया ना चार, 2 raised to the power 2. Okay, मान लो कुछ ऐसा होता. Yeah, सोच लो कुछ ऐसा है. यहाँ पर मैंने क्लोरीन लगा दिया. Yeah, so over here you will have 2 raised to the power 3. इतने आइसोमर बन जाएंगे. सो दैट्स हाउ इट वर्क्स इन टर्म्स ऑफ द टोटल नंबर ऑफ ज्योमेट्रिकल आइसोमर्स. ठीक है, 2 रेज टू द पावर एन. बट नाउ थिंक अबाउट द केस दैट वी स्टार्टेड ऑफ विथ. ओके, अपन ने क्या केस डिस्कस किया था चालू में? कि यार ये वाला. नाउ पीपल, दिस इज अ सिमेट्रिक स्ट्रक्चर. यस, दिस इज सिमेट्रिक स्ट्रक्चर, इजंट इट? ठीक है, सो ये यहां पे दोनों है अभी. लेट्स ट्राई टू मेक एन इजी आइसोमर ऑफ दिस. ओके, तो ये बनाते हैं अभी. ठीक है, ये क्या है? दिस गाय ओवर हियर इज ई, दिस गाय ओवर हियर इज जी. ठीक है, नाउ लेट्स ट्राई टू मेक वेयर दिस इज ई एंड दिस इज ई. ठीक है, सो ऐसे बनाता हूं मैं. डू यू सी बोथ ऑफ देम आर द सेम स्ट्रक्चर्स? इसको पलट दो. बोथ ऑफ देम आर द सेम स्ट्रक्चर्स बिकॉज ऑफ सिमेट्री. यस, सो इन द केस ऑफ सिमेट्रिकल स्ट्रक्चर्स द फॉर्मूला इज अ लिटिल मोर complicated. ठीक है, in case of symmetrical cases the formula is a little more complicated. So total number of geometrical isomers is equal to 2 to the power n minus 1 plus 2 to the power p minus 1, where p is equal to n by 2 where n is even, p is equal to n plus 1 by 2 where n is odd. ठीक है, so मान लो तुम्हें ऐसा केस निकालना है. ओके, ये बनाया, ये बनाया, ये बनाया, ये, ये और ये, सिमेट्रिकल. ठीक है, symmetrical. So what is N over here? N is equal to 3. So what is P over here? P is equal to N plus 1 by 2. So P kya hoga? 3 plus 1 by 2, that is 2. So total number of geometrical isomers that I can get in this case, okay, is equal to, geometrical isomers are equal to 2 to the power n minus 1, that is 3 minus 1, plus 2 to the power 2 minus 1, 2 square plus 2, okay. So ye kitna aa gaya? Ye aa gaya 4 plus 2. Theek hai? Got it? That's how you do this case. But trust me, seldom will questions come on this. If you wish to note it down, please a screenshot le lena. Okay? Chalo. Ab apan karenge thode cases where we have to decide whether we get geometrical isomerism or not. Okay, so this is the final leg of the class. So we'll have like 4 or 5 questions. We'll just have to decide whether it shows geometrical isomerism or not. Let's look at this case. What's the restricted rotation over here? What's the restricted rotation over here? Ring to choti si hai, to wahan to kuch sochna hi nahi apne ko. Anyway, if there were substituents like this over here, yeah, then we would have thought about geometrical isomerism. So no substituents on the ring over there. We don't have to think much about it. The only restricted center of rotation is this guy, isn't it? Achha ji. So once again, we form a line on the right hand side. Both are CH3, so both are same on the same hand, same side. Hence, it doesn't show geometrical isomerism. As simple as that. Even if you look at the left hand side, theek hai? Ek line bana raha hu main just to show you that upar aur niche, top and bottom is the same thing, right? So this guy will not show geometrical isomerism. You must be thinking, sir, what about this case then? Let's say apan aisa kuch bana hai. What about this case then? Will this show geometrical isomerism? No. Because on the left hand side, top and bottom is the same thing, right? Now, to clear your confusion about this guy, if you have a confusion, let's say, use the template method, okay? Iska template banao, kaisa dikhega? The template will look something like this. Try to fit its other isomer in the template by flipping this. Bade aram se fit ho jayega, yes? Let's say you make the other isomer. Let's say you call these two isomers of each other, no? Isko palat ke aise rakh do. Yeah, take the structure out, ghumao, and keep it in the template. Same thing, hence no geometrical isomerism. Cool. So this does not show geometrical isomerism. Let's look at the next case. Next case is interesting. Ye batao bhai. Does this show geometrical isomerism or not? One way is to see left, right. Right side pe CH3 and hydrogen. Different. Left side pe. Go on the top, go on the bottom. Okay, maan lo tum do log chal rahe ho. Okay, let's say twins are walking over here. This guy will get a different type of a path. This guy is getting a different type of a path. Yes. Upar tumhe CH3 mila, niche CH3 nahi mila. So since the path is different, this guy is also different. Okay, aise imagine kar lo. Upar alag, niche alag. Both of these things look different, hence different. Another way would be to think about the template. Another way would be to think about the template. Template kaise sochoge? Ye bana lo iske around. Think about this template, yes. Let's make its isomer. Isomer kaisa dikhega? Six membered ring. Double bond ke niche aise bana do. This can be its isomer. Can you fit it on top of that template? Nah, right? Because even if you try to fit this over here, this will not fit. If you try to fit this over here, this will come downstairs. Hai na? Isko aise palat do, to ye to yahan ghus jayega, but this guy will have no place to sit. So these two are geometrical isomers of each other. So yes, this does show geometrical isomerism. Awesome. Let's look at this case. Ooh, sir, ye kya kar diya? What about this case? C double bond C double bond C HCH3. Oh, oh, oh. Ab kya karenge? Imagine the carbon, two carbon double bond. Single bond bana dete hain pehle to. Theek hai ji. Ab in do carbon mein, let us say the pi bonds are overlapped like this in the plane of the screen itself.
People, do you realize this carbon is an sp hybridized carbon?
Chamka, ye sp hybrid carbon hai na. Ab kya ho raha hai yahan pe? That this carbon has another p orbital which is binding with the p orbital of this guy. Can that p orbital be on top of this? No, of course not. So over here, main isko erase kar deta hu. The other p orbital is going to be perpendicular to this p orbital, yes? To wo exist karega, maan lo aise. This is on the plane of your desk. These are like this. Okay? And the black ones are like that. ये ऐसे पड़े हुए हैं, okay? This black and red exist on the same carbon itself. तो ऐसा सीन है कुछ. चमका? ठीक है? This is what is happening over here. Got it? Hybrid orbitals and unhybrid orbitals are perpendicular to each other. This is what the CH3 will be like behind the screen, and this is what the hydrogen will be like. Okay, I'll give you a visualizable image as well. That hydrogen and CH3 will be in the plane of the screen itself. So yahan pe ek hydrogen rahega, yahan pe CH3 rahega. You must be wondering, sir, ye chamka nahi? Show us with the pens, please. Chamak raha na kya keh raha hu main? Got it? Yeah. So doesn't this look like a tetrahedral carbon situation? ऐसे ही लग रहा है ना, ये टेट्राहेड्रल कार्बन जैसा अगर ये प्लेन में लाए. या सो दीज टू आर इन द प्लेन ऑफ द स्क्रीन, दीज टू आर इन द प्लेन ऑफ योर डेस्क. दैट्स द आइडिया ओवर हियर. नाउ कैन दिस शो ज्योमेट्रिकल आइसोमेरिज्म? लेट्स ड्रॉ द डैश वेज स्ट्रक्चर. ओके, हाइड्रोजन CH3 एंड हाइड्रोजन. These two structures are entirely the same. You must be wondering, sir, how is that possible? Think about this entire thing. Okay, is puri cheez ko na tum socho jaise ek tetrahedral carbon hai. Think about it like a tetrahedral carbon. Okay, just one tetrahedral carbon. So CH3, this is your hydrogen. Okay, and this is your CH3, this is your hydrogen. Aisa soch lo isko. Yeah, this structure and this structure, are they different? CH3, hydrogen, CH3, hydrogen. They are not different, right? अपन ने सिर्फ थोड़ा सा different तरीके से बना दिया है इसको, yes? The relative orientation of these two CH3s is still like this. यहाँ पे ऐसे है, that's all. इसका conclusion बताता हूँ मैं तुम्हें, okay? I'll tell you the conclusion that you can remember for later, okay? One double bond, geometrical isomerism will be possible. Two double bonds together, geometrical isomerism will not be possible because ye ek direction mein, ye dusri direction mein hai, yeah? Theek hai? Let's say three double bonds, again possible. Fir aage maan lo four double bonds, not possible. Chamak raha hai ye trend, chamak raha hai tumhe? That's the trend that you have to keep in mind. Okay? Chamka na? So this guy will not show geometrical isomerism. You can think about it in terms of a template as well if you wish to. The template will be 3D now. ठीक है? ये template ऐसा कुछ तो बनेगा जो तुम्हारा ये 3D template होगा, okay? Because one CH3 is over here, one CH3 is over there. तो template पूरा एकदम 3-dimensional visualization if you have, you can keep that in mind. Does this show geometrical isomerism? What have I done? I have fused two cyclobutane rings together. अब इसका क्या करेंगे? देखो, the trick to this type of a question is, think of this cyclobutane thingy as a double bond. ठीक है? फिर यहाँ पे एक और double bond आ गया, so बिल्कुल same चीज हो रही है, okay? ठीक है? ये ring ऐसे है, ये वाला ring, okay? This is like this. The other ring is joined like this, okay? So imagine a pattern of rings where this is first ring, second ring, third ring, fourth ring, fifth ring, sixth ring. Something like that is going on. Okay? So, agar is ring ko main banata hu is plane mein, the next ring is going to be something like this. Yeah. Fundu case, dosto. Isse zyada mazedar nahi ho sakta. Then the next ring, if I have to join, will still be in the plane of the screen. Then the next ring will again look like this. So, ye ring aise chalti hai. Otherwise, just to do the questions of these cases, these are known as spiro compounds. You just think of this whole thing, this whole dabba as a double bond. ठीक है जी. सो याद है टू डबल बॉन्ड्स के केस में ज्योमेट्रिकल आइसोमेरिज्म डजंट एग्जिस्ट, हेंस ओवर हियर एज वेल सिमेट्रिक स्ट्रक्चर, नो ज्योमेट्रिकल आइसोमेरिज्म. इवन मोर इंटरेस्टिंग केस. सो यू विल से सर ऑब्वियसली इट शोज ज्योमेट्रिकल आइसोमेरिज्म बिकॉज नाइट्रोजन के अक्रॉस जो डबल बॉन्ड है उसके अराउंड अपन ऐसे देखें तो यस इट कैन शो ज्योमेट्रिकल आइसोमेरिज्म. थ्योरेटिकली यू आर करेक्ट. व्हाट हैपेंस प्रैक्टिकली, यू नो व्हाट, इफ यू हैव मिस्ड माय क्लास ऑफ एरोमेटिसिटी प्लीज प्लीज मेक श्योर यू सी दैट क्लास. प्रैक्टिकली व्हाट हैपेंस इज दिस स्ट्रक्चर एग्जिस्ट लाइक दिस. मैं बताता हूं ये होता कैसा है स्ट्रक्चर. This exists with a negative charge on it. Why? Do you see this structure now? Aromaticity yaad hai? Do you realize that this guy is becoming aromatic? Yeah? This is what it practically exists like. So there is no center of rotation at all because wo bond khul gaya, it exists in a polar fashion. You must be saying, sir, how do scientists confirm that? Scientists confirm that by looking at the dipole moment. You have a charge separated structure over here. Yeah. So this dipole moment is quite significant. So people realize ki yaar ye to na aromatic hone ke liye this exists in a polarized fashion. Okay, so essentially this double bond is polarized towards nitrogen. This becomes a one electron cyclic conjugation species, hence aromatic. So this practically does not show geometrical isomerism. This is a very special case. If you know this, you know everything about geometrical isomerism. Yeah. Challenging questions today. I thought I would do this today. Chalo, last case. Let's look at the priority order for these cases. This question will also be applicable for optical isomerism. Hence, this right now is a homework for you. Okay? Isko karo as a homework. In the next class, I will first discuss this and then we will discuss about conformational isomers. Okay? And that's it for today's class. You must be wondering, sir, but you haven't told us about dipole moment or why malic acid and fumaric acid actually had such different properties. Don't worry. This part is to be continued and we'll see that on Monday. So please join me for that class. Until then, please like, share and subscribe. I am Pahul signing off. See you very soon.